Hey everybody, it's Jim McGuinn for Teenage Kicks, and this week I am just back from Iceland Airwaves, sporting my warm wool Icelandic sweater, and it's Björk's birthday. So we're going to celebrate her music this week on Teenage Kicks. Björk Goodman's daughter, that is her name, her full name. Her mother was Hildur. She's an activist, a protester of the aluminum companies that dominate a lot of the industry in Iceland. Her father, an electrician. He's written technical training books for electricians and served on the Reykjavik City Council. His name is Goodman Gunnarsson, which is why her name is Björk Goodman's daughter. That's how they do the names in Iceland. It's a little confusing, but it works. Now, as a young girl, she was studying classical music, and at age 11, she sang a song at a school concert and floored everybody. They sent the tape to the one radio station in Iceland. Yes, the one radio station in Iceland at the time, RUV, who played it on the national airwaves, and she got a record deal. At age 11, Björk made her first solo record back in 1977. So while The Clash and Johnny Rotten were screaming about taking down the man, she was covering the Beatles and singing in this beautiful, tender voice as at a young age. Now, in the early 80s, she had evolved a little bit, and she was in a punk band called Spit and Snot, then Tapi Takaras, Roka Roka Drum, Got Cooled, and then Kukul. And that was an album that was made by that band and included most of the future Sugar Cubes. So they started back in 1986 and translated their songs to English in 87. They had huge critical buzz in the UK and in North America. Quick, name a band before the Sugar Cubes from Iceland. You can't, because they were really the first band that kind of got out of Iceland and achieved international fame, paving the way for Sigur Rós and so many artists that have come since. Now, after three albums with the Sugar Cubes, Björk went solo. Her first album called Debut in 93, and it really began a journey that's taken her far away from the poppy punk songs of the Sugar Cubes. She's been an award-winning actress. She's worked to release albums with unique packaging and digital content. She's had amazing videos, swan dresses, and just generally been a really captivating artist now for many, many years. So happy birthday to her this week. And instead of me on the uke and trying to sing a Björk song, we're turning it over to someone who can do a Björk song justice, Minnesota artist Katy Vernon. She often performs in her bands on the uke, so it's very natural for her to just nail a Björk song for us. Have a great week. Thanks for tuning in. Saturday mornings, 8 to 10, it's Teenage Kicks on The Current.
This week's featured artist is Björk. And like many people, I was introduced to her when she was the featured singer in the band The Sugar Cubes. And I thought I'd play a fun little song on my new ukulele. My new Minnesota-made ukulele, and I hope you like it.